Hey everybody, how's it going? Today, let's take a detailed look at the newly refreshed 2013 Ram 1500 Laramie. And this is going to be a detailed, in-depth view of the Ram. We'll start it up, show the engine, get an exhaust clipping over the performance data, and show you a bunch of the unique aspects of the interior as well as exterior. And before we begin, I'd like to give a big thanks and special shout out to North Point Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram, located in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, for allowing me to come out and film the all-new 2013 Ram 1500 Laramie. And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start her up. Let her run. As you can see, the vehicle does come standard with a remote start. The new Ram also features an integrated smart key access system. All you have to do is keep the key fob in your pocket and locate the little chrome button on the driver and passenger side door handle. All you have to do to lock is press it. One beep indicates locking, then after waiting a second, grab the handle, there's a touch sensitive pad behind it, and that automatically unlocks the vehicle. The exterior color is known as True Blue Pearl, featuring a light frost beige and canyon brown leather interior. And along with that smart key system, there's also remote push button ignition. To start, all you have to do is put your foot on the brake and hit the dash meta button to go. Beautiful sound. One of the first things you'll notice new for 2013 is the optional thin film transistor liquid crystal display. Basically, it encompasses all the driver information controls, digital speedometer, as well as personalizable options, vehicle diagnostics, all in an easy to see digital display that's nicely blended with the rest of the analog gauges. The steering is now electrically assisted speed proportional rack and pinion, wrapped in a full, soft, supple leather wrapped steering wheel with a unique four spoke design and satin silver covering around the multifunction controls. Also new for V8 equipped model 2013 Rams is the new rebranded Torque Flight 8-speed electronically controlled automatic gearbox fit through this dash mounted gear selector with a knurled aluminum housing. Very simple, easy to use, you just put your foot on the brake and twist it to your desired gear. Once in reverse, an integrated backup camera appears that's mounted inside the tailgate handle with guidance lines that automatically adjust as you turn the wheel. The mirrors also tilt down when the vehicle is put in reverse, and all of your four-wheel drive controls are located below the gear selector. The 8-speed allows better performance to come out of the V8 versus the old 5-speed unit, and allows for better fuel economy too versus last year's model. So let's go ahead and flip on the automatic headlamps, fog lamps, as well as the hazards. Your cargo bed light is located right underneath that. The driver and passenger side windows are fully automatic with laminated glass for better noise insulation and safety. And we'll check out the exterior, shall we? The interior also chimed, letting you know it's loss detection of the proximity key fob. The Dodge Ram has been with us now for over three decades, being first introduced back in 1981. Now referred to as simply the Ram nameplate,
Chrysler Group is setting their bar high to provide a lineup of trucks and vans that are not only modern, but efficient. In today's competitive truck market, people expect a lot out of their trucks. Power, performance, and capability are paramount, but even more so this day and age is overall efficiency. The current generation Ram pickups first hit the market back in 2009. For 2013, all Ram pickups receive styling updates inside and out, but it's the entry payload half-ton trucks that get a big dose of refinement, economy, and performance. In fact, it was actually named Motor Trend's 2013 Truck of the Year. Many of the changes seen here will also apply to the 2014 heavy-duty Ram trucks as they hit the market. This year, styling, while overall familiar, has been polished up with softer lines up front, combination xenon LED headlamps and LED tail lamps. Laramie and Laramie Longhorn models are the top luxury trim lines and feature the most glitz and glamour, more reminiscent of a Chrysler 300 than a truck. One of Ram's signature advances was the introduction of a coil rear suspension back in 2009. This continues today and can be now had with the new optional adjustable air ride suspension. This allows for variable spring rates. Whether you're loaded down with cargo or passengers, you now have more flexibility and stability compared with a single rate provided by traditional leaf springs. The air suspension is optional on both quad and crew cab models only. It allows the driver to adjust ride height depending on if they're driving off-road or on the highway. The modern-day airbags and equipment are built to withstand more abuse and be more durable in resisting tears and punctures over the long haul. Overall, there's five settings. The two off-road modes allow you to lift the truck either 1.2 inches or 2 inches off the standard height, and there's even an aero mode that lowers it 0.6 inches for highway cruising, and in park mode, lowers it even further for easier entry and exit. Combine that with the smoother front end and optional active grille shutters that automatically close at highway speeds, the Ram engineers were able to increase aerodynamic efficiency by 6% by decreasing the overall coefficient of drag from 0.39 to 0.36. The new Ram is also lighter than last year's offering, partly due to the use of high-strength steel throughout the frame and chassis, saving approximately 30 pounds. In the bed, new box floor cross members remove 7 pounds, and a new front bumper design decreases 4 pounds. Other weight-saving measures include aluminum, lower control arms in the front suspension, and an additional 26 pounds saved by a new aluminum hood. The new 8-speed transmission saves about 30 pounds by itself in V8 models, but with the new V6 and 8-speed transmission combination, it's a total of 76 pounds with that application, which really helps boost the V6 fuel economy. For 2013, depending on your trim level, there's also a variety of bed lengths and the option of a spray-on bed liner. Short boxes measure 5 feet 7 inches, there's a new 6 foot 4 inch medium-sized bed, and also the 8 foot long bed, of course depending on your trim level. Payload and towing capacity for V8 models is around 1,600 and just over 10,000 pounds respectively, while V6 models are around 1,500 and 6,500 pounds respectively. The optional Ram boxes that can be affixed to either side of the bed can also be locked via remote for this year, adding to the increased security. It'll also lock the tailgate. The Ram Laramie comes standard with 20-inch chrome-clad aluminum alloy wheels wrapped in Goodyear tires measuring 275/60. Brakes consist of four-wheel discs, ventilated in front with 13.2-inch rotors and 13.8-inch rotors in the rear. This brings the new Ram to a stop from 60 miles an hour in approximately 129 feet. Not too bad for such a large vehicle. The front suspension is independent with a short and long arm design and coil springs, with a multi-link rear, coil springs, and front and rear stabilizer bars. The high-strength steel used in the chassis increases stability and precision, but also does wonders to decrease noise, vibration, and harshness, not to mention with larger body mounts in the front frame and C-pillars. The remainder of the chassis is hydroformed, which decreases welding points and potential sites of weakness, and, in the process, reduces weight further and helps keep it more stable. Overall length is 229 inches with a width of 79.4 inches and a height of 77.6 inches. Total curb weight for this particular equipped model is right around 5,600 pounds.
And we're going to pop the hood.
This Ram we have here features the optional 5.7 liter Hemi V8, now with variable valve timing. Rather than feeding in forced induction or radically redesigning, Ram is enhancing the existing engine for better economy and performance. It's of traditional pushrod design, 16 valve with an iron block, aluminum heads, and port fuel injection. It produces a healthy 395 horsepower at 5,600 RPM and 407 pound-feet of torque at 3,950 RPM. This translates to a 0-60 time of 6.9 seconds and a quarter mile time of 12.4 seconds at 88.6 miles per hour. The biggest piece of news though is the new V6. With the 3.6 liter Pentastar V6 replacing the outdated 3.7 liter unit, horsepower is up 42% to 305 horsepower, and 13% more torque to 269 pound-feet, and 20% better fuel economy with 17 miles to a gallon in the city and 25 on the highway with a 26-gallon tank and regular and lighter fuel. V8 models are expected to be a few miles per gallon less in both scenarios. There's also an auto start-stop feature that shuts off engine power momentarily when you come to a complete stop, as seen in other vehicles. Once you let your foot off the brake, the vehicle automatically starts back up and is ready to go. You can turn it on or off at your leisure. Aside from all of the driving enhancements and capability, the other thing the new Ram benefits from is an all-new interior featuring wonderful build quality for a pickup. Many of the touch points are soft padded or rubberized materials, while in upper trim levels you receive stitch padding, especially going across the dash and speedometer cluster. Stepping on up to the Laramie Longhorn, and the interior is tailored with unique saddle leather seats and unique embossments. This is one of the more upscale looking two-tone interior colors featuring color accent stitching and plenty of chrome bright work. Satin finish wood coming across the doors and plenty of storage across the door handle pocket and down below with integrated cup holders. The seats feature plenty of padding, full leather buckets with perforations coming down the middle for the heating and cooling function. The Laramie logo is embossed on the back of the seat with adjustable headrests and adjustable seat belts. They also feature full power adjustment located down below, your standard adjustments off to the left, your power lumbar, and two-person memory. The lateral grip is pretty decent, expecting what you would get out of a pickup, more for comfort versus sport. Plenty of airbags all the way around, keeping everything nice and safe, and just overall sitting in it and feeling in it, given the overall feeling of the vehicle, makes it seem like a much higher quality vehicle than you would expect in just a pickup category. Across the bottom, you have the rich brown carpeting, manual tilting steering wheel with power pedal adjust. In the Laramie trim, you have the soft padded trim coming across the entire portion of the dash with the color accent stitching, and with the Alpine premium audio system, you also have a little aluminum identifier tag in the mid-range speaker, all accented by satin silver across the center console and subtle chrome touches around the dash.
So let's go ahead and see if she sounds. You gotta love that awesome muscular sound from the standard dual exhaust. And we're going to shut her up. Nice and tight. Now this particular Ram Laramie comes with the optional 9-speaker, 506-watt Alpine surround sound system with rear-mounted subwoofer. Now, also new for 2013, fed through the 8.4-inch Garmin Mobile Media Telemetrics Navigation Interface with touchscreen capability and standard Sirius XM satellite radio. Side curtain airbags. Auto-dimming rearview mirror with integrated 911 alert assist. And up top, you have your full LED interior illumination, garage home link, as well as the power control for the rear window. You can see a little bit more in depth here the color accent stitching across the padded material on the dash. And to the increased interior build quality, adds a nice elegant touch. The Ram logo and a little storage tray amongst the wood grain,
and a satin silver housing accented by chrome around the air vents. Nice and attractive layout. Now, as far as the infotainment system, it's really, really easy to use and pick up on. Personally, it's one of my favorite systems. The graphics are really good. It's nice and big without being too overbearing in the dash, and everything's really well laid out compared to some of the other systems on the market. For example, this is your main radio screen. You have all of your preset stations up top, your temperature up top, clock, and outside temperature. Your different radio modes are here. All of the system options are down below there. Radio and song information. You can dual wield your map, as well as add favorite stations, songs, artists, so it'll automatically bring up a little reminder every time it comes on the air. If you hit browse, it'll bring up all of the stations, your presets, favorites, sports, traffic and weather, replay. So with the integrated hard drive, it actually starts recording the music whenever you start listening to it. So if you wanted to double back and hear a lyric again, you can easily hit rewind and go back to that spot. Manual tune, your traffic and weather, and audio, where you can do the balance and fade, your different equalizer settings, speed compensated volume, as well as your surround sound. Down below are your different media options. So you have iPod, auxiliary, USB integration, SD card input, CD, hands-free Bluetooth streaming of audio, a whole lot of different options, so it's pretty flexible. Your controls basically contain your heated steering wheel, your heated and ventilated seats, two-stage. You can also bring up your settings here, so all of the personalizable options of the vehicle. Climate, so you have your different zones, front and rear defrost, one-touch automatic, temperature, fan speed down below, and you can also access your seats and heated steering wheel from that screen. Navigation, like I said, it's Garmin-based. As you can see, it's very quick. It's also been updated since last year's model too, or last year's version and some of the other Chrysler Group products. Real-time traffic updates, emergency assistance, your hands-free Bluetooth telephone, integrated dialing pad storing messages and contacts, and voice dialing. Also, the Uconnect apps. What's also pretty neat about this system also, it also doubles as a Wi-Fi hotspot, so it actually has 3G signal that you can see over in the side corner. So you can have apps, Sirius Travel Link, which basically includes your fuel prices, your weather map, or real-time weather updates, movies, sports. So as you can see, it's packed full of features, very easy to use and quick to pick up on. I highly suggest checking out in person. And as we come down the wood accent center console, you have a button to turn the screen off, back, and other radio controls for the system. And you can also control your climate control from down below here, so the same adjustments if you didn't have, actually want to go through the screen and do it that way. Down below you have an integrated trailer brake, your traction control, tow haul mode, which raises the shift points for better performance while towing, heated and ventilated seating, as well as your steering wheel activation, also if you didn't want to go through the control setup through the screen. Your four-wheel drive controls are located right below the gear shift knob. The radio and air conditioning control knobs also feature a knurled pattern just like the gear selector, but they're coated in rubber. Integrated storage in the center console, chrome accented with a 12-volt power outlet, two cup holders over there, another storage pocket, and two more cup holders down below here. Padded center console, it's two-tier. Chain storage, your different media options for your USB, auxiliary, SD, as well as another 12-volt power outlet. And a deep storage well down below that. Now off to the right-hand side, you have your cruise control, as well as the manual gear selection I touched on earlier. And off to the left, your hands-free telephone, voice command control, as well as your driver information controls. Help.
Say the station you want to listen to. For example, say, tune to satellite channel ESPN radio. Or, to listen to a preset station, say something like, tune to preset 5. You can interrupt this help message by pressing the voice button. To play music, say things like, change source to iPod. Or change source to Bluetooth. You can also say things like, show Major League Baseball. Canceled.
So it's pretty self-explanatory. Your radio controls, in traditional Chrysler fashion, are located behind the steering wheel. As far as the driver info system located in this new TFT display, off to the far left, it shows you which one you're currently selected on. You just use those little directional arrows on the left-hand side of the steering column. So you have vehicle info, fuel economy, trip computers, trailering data, audio, messages. You can customize which shows up in which quadrant areas. Instantaneous miles to a gallon. Vehicle temperature. So it's pretty neat. You have all of your vehicle diagnostics. And a very comprehensive layout with plenty of gauges. Alrighty. And we'll go ahead and shut her down. And we'll check out the back seat.
As you'd expect in a full-size pickup, backseat room is plentiful, especially for people over 6 feet. The refreshed styling comes across the door panels. Keep those backseat passengers as luxurious as the front. The backseat is pretty versatile too. It can flip up easily, just grabbing it, pulling up. There's LED illumination underneath. And you can fold out this little tray and pull out these little stands here. So it'll rest, make a nice hard surface so you can load in more cargo underneath in space. Same goes for the other side, and I'll show that when we get over there. Like I said, I'm about 5'11", probably have about 5-6 inches of head space, and probably at least the same, if not more, of leg space. Plenty of room to stretch out. Cup holders down below, a 12-volt power outlet, and the back seats are also heated two-stage. Speakers mounted up in the ceiling for the surround sound. Rear coat hooks. As well as side curtain airbags for the rear. Not bad at all. We're gonna check out the rest of the vehicle, shall we? The door is open almost 90 degrees, so it's very easy to get in and out. You also have similar power adjustments on the passenger seat that you find on the driver's. Your jack is also located under the passenger seat. Two-tier glove box. The
The 2013 Ram lineup is a perfect example of how modern and range-topping the new truck market can be. With great model flexibility, efficiency, performance, and technology, it's quite the well-rounded vehicle. A truck for those who don't want to feel like they're driving a truck.
Well, everyone, I hope you enjoyed this detailed look at the newly refreshed 2013 Ram 1500 Laramie. Be sure to stay tuned next time. There's a lot more where that came from. Take care, everybody.